Good morning, YouTube. So it's 0600 hours. We're here at Luke Air Force Base. We're currently filling in for Starbucks that's located inside the BX here at Luke Air Force Base. They're remodeling their store, so Luke has contacted us and asked us to come in and fill in, and we gladly did so. But I wanted to just kind of give you guys a quick look inside the trailer, a little more in-depth look at inside the trailer, because we've had a lot of, you know, a lot of people asking, a lot of people interested in building a trailer, or they're in the middle of building a trailer. One thing I did want to address, I had a question the other day. Somebody was asking if 35 gallons of fresh water is enough. That's what we use. We've done large events, anywhere from 45,000 people. You know, we've never ran out of water, but we've come close to it with an event that size. Typically, you know, you're looking at $3,000 day before you run out of water. So you're not going to have those every day. You know, the other misconception is a lot of people think that when you are going to do something like this, that you're just going to come out of the gate and you're going to make millions of dollars. You know, it's hard. Some people, their thought is that they are going to, you know, hit 100 sales or 100 cups a day, and, you know, average $5 per cup, and you're going to make $500 a day, 6 days a week, 7 days a week, 5 days a week, whatever it may be. Realistically, 100 cups is a lot when you're in a mobile coffee truck. You know, so not to shoot anybody down, but I want to be realistic with you guys. You know, can you be successful? Yes, you can be. We came out our first year, we did $80,000 in sales. You know, this year we're on track to definitely beating that. I don't want to put numbers out there, but we are definitely on track to beating our sales for our first year. So you can be successful at this. You can make a lot of money, but don't think that, you know, you're just gonna kill it, man, and you're gonna be the next Starbucks right away. You know, again, not knocking anybody. I just want to be realistic. Can you be that? Yeah, you can, absolutely. You know, you work hard, definitely can do whatever you want, but you know, just know it's gonna take a lot of work, it's gonna take a lot of time, it's gonna take a lot of effort. So anyway, without further ado, I'm gonna take you guys inside our trailer. It is 6x10. We run a Honda EU 7000 IS quiet generator. So a Honda EU 7000 IS. They run, I think Honda right now has a sale on them for about $4,200. Well worth it though. If you can do it, well worth it. You know, nothing better than customers not having to yell over your generator while they're putting an order in. So yeah, we run 35 gallons. Our fresh water comes in right here. I have it hooked up to a Sure water source back here. While we're temporarily here at Luke, we don't always have that convenience, but then it flows. Let me go ahead and turn this around real quick. And it flows in through the wall down and into our fresh water. This is our water heater. We run a 6 gallon instant electric water heater, RO system, 3-phase RO, goes into our 35 gallon tank. We have a 3-compartment sink, which we do not technically need to have since we are a push cart and not a food truck. We also have a hand washing sink, 250-pound ice bin. This bin just holds ice for us, and it'll hold ice, you know, 1 to 2 weeks, but it just holds ice for us. It does not make ice. You can, we can add a ice machine maker thing, but up there, but currently that's going to take a lot of power, a lot of water, just resources that we don't have, so we just use it strictly for a large ice chest. We've got a refrigerator system here. two doors. You can see it stores quite a bit. Cold brew, cannolis, refreshers, extra material, whatever. The other thing a lot of people want to know, our machine, it is 220. We run a two group, Nuova Simonelli, and a Simonelli grinder with doser. You know, knock boxes, and then we store all of our syrups up top. You know, again, we're 6x10, so we have to make a lot of use of space that we don't have. And that's just 6x10 inside. Now, if you look here, between the ice chest and the counter, I have about, I don't know, foot and a half room. So not much. You know, here from counter to counter there, these are about a foot each. So I've got about 3.5-4 feet of room here. Countertop here is about 3 feet. So that's all cutting into space, you know. So we have to make do with the space that we have. But as you can see, I mean, it's a fairly efficient setup. We can do anything out of here. I mean, currently we're doing well over 100 cups a day here in this location. We're here 7 days a week, you know, and I think yesterday we did like, I don't know, 90 something transactions, some being, you know, 3 cups, 4 cups per transaction. We haven't ran out of water, but you know, that's a lot. I mean, realistically, we're manning a Starbucks that is the only Starbucks on base. You know, we're the only coffee. So we're catching all that business that they have, and we're able to do it out of this trailer with one person at a time. I work the morning shift from 06 to 12, and my wife comes in and works 12 to 1800 hours, and then we shut it down. So, you know, what they're doing in there with all that space, 3-4 employees, we're able to do out of, I don't know, 1/10 of the space that they have with, you know, 1/4 of the employees. So it is an efficient setup. Some people would like to go larger, and I completely understand that. It would be nice to have more room. I will say this, though, that because we are so small, it has worked out in our favor at times where larger trucks can't get into events that we can get into because we are such a small footprint. So, you know, keep that in mind too. You know, yeah, it's cool to have this huge setup, you know, with all this leg room inside. But there might be some, I don't know, wedding events or farmers markets or whatever that just cannot accommodate a large truck. You know, we've done multi-million-dollar house party that we had to get the trailer through a tiny back gate, you know, an RV gate where and maneuver it. So there's no way a large, you know, UPS sized truck would have been able to get in there. So, you know, you gotta keep in mind what it is that you're using it for. Do you wanna sacrifice the space inside for possibly being able to do events that other people can't do? Do you wanna have a large space? Are you gonna be mobile constantly, or do you have a permanent location that you can set your mobile spot up at? All those things taken into consideration, and then base your trailer size off of your needs. That's my suggestion. So anyway, again, not very big, 6x10. Realistically, it's more like, I don't know, inside 3x4. So, and I apologize, guys. I just had surgery on Monday, so I'm still a little raspy from being intubated. But yeah, I hope this video helps out. And then, real quick, I'll take you guys around to show you. Oh, that's the other thing. So we put photos up. You know, people love to see what it is they're ordering. So that's another thing on the outside of your setup. You know, I highly suggest putting some photos. Coffee one, baby. Anyway, so our generator plugs in just right here. Like I said, it's just plugged right into the side there. As you can tell, it's super quiet, so I'm not even having to yell over it just to film it. I'm standing right next to it. So again, you know, keep that in mind too. You can go and get a Harbor Freight generator and they'll work. You know, if you don't have the funds, because you're just starting up and you're putting a lot of money into your business as a startup, completely get it. I understand. You know, my suggestion would be make do with what you have until you can afford, you know, something a little bit more, I guess, luxurious. I don't know. For me, it's not, it is a luxury, but it's also customer etiquette. You know, it keeps our customers from having to yell over a generator or not be able to hear you or be drowned out by noise. Sometimes it sucks when you invest, a ton of money, a good chunk of change in a good generator, and you pull up next to a truck that is rocking a Harbor Freight generator, and you know yours is ultra quiet, but they're just drowning them and you out. You know, you're kind of like, well, shit. Good thing I got, you know, the super quiet generator, and you're over here pumping all this noise. But you know, you can't control that. You can only control what it is that you do and what you're offering your customer. Plus, it's probably going to save your ears in the long run too. So anyway, yeah, if you have any questions, you know, feel free to shoot us a message. We'll try to return them. We are pretty busy as of lately. Like I said, we're doing a 7-day operation, 7-day a week operation for the next couple months. But I'll definitely try to, you know, answer any questions that you might have. You know, we want everybody to succeed. We know everybody out there that's trying to get into this is just simply trying to do the same thing it is that my wife and I are doing. It's been great for us. It's allowed us to have a lot more time with one another, with our child, and you know, yeah. I mean, we're not millionaires, but our bills are paid, so you can be successful. And you know, so if we can help you out along the way, we'd love to help you out. All right, guys, make sure you click subscribe. Post your comments in the section below. Again, I apologize. We're not super flashy with the videos. I'll have a team that comes in and makes all kinds of cool shit, and I don't know how to do freaking the intros and all that stuff on the computer. But, you know, we'll get the information out to you. All right, guys. Cheers.